SDXL 1.0 is finally out. You can use it to generate all these amazing images and more. It can do various styles, types, subjects, backgrounds, and so much more, all for free. Here are some more realistic examples, some more anime style examples, and some random stuff that I found interesting. So how do you use it? I'll show you three methods. The first is running it locally using Automatic 1111, the most popular UI for Stable Diffusion. I'll also show you how to run it locally with ComfyUI, which had the best support for SDXL since launch and also natively supports SDXL Refiner. And finally, if you aren't able to run it locally for whatever reason, I'll show you how to use it online for free. So to run it locally, you first need to grab the SDXL 1.0 base model, which should be good enough for most people, but optionally you can also download the Refiner model as well. This is not required for Auto 1111. To do so, just go to the Hugging Face repository by Stability AI that I'll link in the comments and click the download button on the save tensor files of the base model as well as the Refiner model. To use it in Automatic 1111, first go to the official GitHub repository with over 90,000 stars that I'll link below. Unlike my previous tutorial, you don't need to install Python or Git this time since we'll be using the pre-built file. Scroll down to installing and running, and under installation on Windows 10 11 with the NVIDIA GPUs, click the v1.0.0 pre hyperlink. Now click on sd.webui.zip to download the compressed file. After the download has finished, please extract it using whatever tool you'd like. Now copy the earlier downloaded SDXL base model and paste it after going in sd.webui, the webui folder, then the models folder, and finally the Stable Diffusion folder. Now all you need to do is run the update.bat script by double clicking it. This will just update the code to the latest version, which supports SDXL. Now similarly, double click run.bat. This step might take some time as it will download and install all the required dependencies such as PyTorch. After it has finished installing, it will start the server on localhost 7860. You can control click the link in the terminal to launch it in your own default browser. You can also close everything, and now if you double click run.bat, it will start the web server every time since it has already installed everything. Let's try generating an image by entering a positive prompt God of Flowers fantasy setting and a negative prompt worst quality. And it generates a cool looking artwork, but that's not exactly what we're looking for. Since SDXL was primarily trained on 1024x1024 sized images, it generates much better if we just change the width and height to that. This does double the time taken to generate, but it generates actual images based on our prompt. You don't have to stick to 1024x1024. For example, if you want a landscape image, you can use 1366x768 or any of these other resolutions that are also natively supported. Again, the time taken to generate will probably increase, but it does a pretty good job at generation. Now let's try a photorealistic prompt as well. Honestly, much better face and details than 0.9. Let's do some landscape generation as well. And super interesting results. I've only ever generated square results, so this was nice. Now, if Auto 1111 doesn't work, or if it's too slow, or if you want to use the Refiner model as well, ComfyUI might be a better choice for you. So all you need to do is go to the official GitHub repo of ComfyUI that I'll link below and click on installing ComfyUI, or just scroll down and click on direct link to download. Or you can go to the releases page and this top download link will download the latest stable build, and this bottom link will download the latest unstable build. We'll just use this latest stable build for now. After downloading, we just need to extract the 7-zip file using your favorite utility. After extracting, go within the ComfyUI folder, then the models folder, then the checkpoints folder, and paste your SDXL 1.0 base and refine models here that you had downloaded earlier. Now, all you need to do is double-click the run nvidia.gpu.bat file if you have an NVIDIA GPU, or alternatively the run cpu.bat file if you don't. This will launch ComfyUI in a new browser window on localhost 8188. If you had pasted the model in the correct folder, it would automatically be loaded here. If you have other models as well, you can use the drop-down to select the SDXL base model and reload. Now, let's enter the same positive prompt and a similar negative prompt. Let's change the sampler to Eulerray, and let's change the width and height of the empty latent image to 1024 and 2024. Let's do a landscape generation as well. Wow, this is the first time I've had this color and design. Now, let's add the refiner model. We can add nodes and create a new workflow, but for now, click on load and load this refine.json file, which was for SDXL 0.9, but should work fine with 1.0 as well. This is courtesy of Cabin Drew. Now, make sure to load the actual refiner model in the load checkpoint of the refiner and the base model in the load checkpoint of the base. After loading the refiner, let's generate and compare. It might take slightly longer since we're using a different sampler, but feel free to experiment. It first generates a base image and then feeds that image along with the prompt back into the refiner. As you can see, the refiner model added a lot more details to the face, the background, and small minor details to the variety and kind of flowers, textures, shades, and lighting. Let's generate one more image, this time a landscape one. Interesting results, slightly more detailed face and hand, at least one of them. Changed the crown from gold to plants, and some minor details and touches here and there. Again, let's try the same photorealistic prompt that we had used in Auto1111 earlier. And another one with landscape resolution. Okay, if both of these weren't able to run due to hardware limitation or software errors, for now you can try it on clipdrop.co, which is a product by Stability AI, the company behind SDXL. There is a limit to the number of free generation, but this should give you an idea about its capabilities. I'll make a video on how to run it on Colab properly, since there are some resources available, but they aren't that fast or optimized for SDXL yet. Do subscribe for more stuff with SDXL, including LoRa training, Dream Booth, Control Net, running on low VRAM devices, etc. I'll see you soon, hopefully after I've gotten over this cold. Bye.